And in the first car, in small letters, it said, "All you see is," and then, you know, big, you know, black silver letters, it said,
"Style in progress."
Boys and girls, listen up. Right now, I want everybody to come to the front. That's right, move forward. I want all the poppers and the breakers to form this circle. I want all the poppers, the breakers, the writers and the exciters to get in this circle and make it real live, yo. Live
from Toronto. Sweet touch.
What's your name?
My name is Mike Herman.
And what are you doing here?
Well, I'm here painting for Bell Canada, Style in Progress, and City of Toronto, a mutual joint project that's been done together as a public beautification project. We're painting on the utility boxes. It used to be just a brown box. Now we've added a bit of color.
So how do you feel about adding your creative outlook or your art into this area, Jane and Finch?
That's a good question. I mean, as I look around, I definitely don't see that, like, graffiti tagging is a problem around here. I don't think it's really a part of the subculture in this neighborhood. I mean, yes, there's some graffiti, but there really, it's not as prevalent as it is in the city. I just think, doing something colorful, there's definitely a lack of colorfulness in the architecture, in the city planning, and I think this is, you know, helping to add some more flavor to this area, I guess.
And at the end of that, there is again something else.
Let's see what you have here.
The public should, more than anything, I guess my message would be, don't be scared. Graffiti's not about gangs, it's not about violence, it doesn't lead to urban decay or anything like that. Graffiti's just about a bunch of guys trying to make art.
Thank you. Next, please.
Well, for Bell and the city to support this, I think that's actually a big step for graffiti writers in Toronto. Because you've got a major corporation like Bell that is providing us with the money and the means and the surfaces to paint this on, and in my opinion they're not exploiting us, which is excellent, because a lot of corporations have exploited graffiti writers in the past for advertising means. And for this, we're not really advertising Bell, you know, we're not actually. None of these paintings have anything to do with Bell. They're for the community, and they are for, you know, from the artist's expression. And from the city, it shows that they actually do acknowledge that graffiti is art, and there are different types of graffiti. Of course, there's the stuff that, you know, is more mischievous and more vandalism, I guess. Vandalism exists, of course. But when you do something like this, we truly don't believe this is vandalism, and the city is finally saying, yes, this is not vandalism, this is art, it has a place in the community.
So take it slow, amigo.
I really got more into like doing graffiti when I finished like graphic design and advertising in school.
Where'd you go to school?
I went to Sheridan for 1 year, then I went to Humber for 2 years, graphic design and advertising, and just like spending all your time in front of a computer, just like clicking your life away. I don't know, it's like no good, no good. It's like, I don't know, never was really that much into art before that, and suddenly after I finished that, I just got like inspiration, and I'm like, man. Like, oh, right there. Yeah, you know.
Nice. How do you guys do this?
Spray paint and stencils. It's like a city project, like it's all Canada. They're actually paying us with spray paint up, which is awesome. Yeah, yeah. Sometimes they arrest you for spray painting, and sometimes they pay you to do it.
Cops chase us,
yeah. Yeah, yeah.